Your Excellencies, President Aliyev, Vice President Aliyev, distinguished speakers, ladies and gentlemen, it is a pleasure, first and foremost, I would say, it is a pleasure to be back to Azerbaijan, our important member state, our young and dynamic democracy in this part of Europe, and a leading country in the field not only of intercultural dialogue, but today in particular in that area. So this is to say that for me it is a pleasure to speak at this World Forum again. I congratulate the authorities of Azerbaijan not only for the organization of this event, but for the Baku process as a whole. And indeed, as we heard from previous speakers, and let me join them, what a successful story is this Baku process. For over a decade, this has provided unrivaled opportunities for experts in the field of intercultural dialogue to share their practice, experience, and understanding. In doing so, the Council of Europe that I represent today in the field of intercultural dialogue and its agenda and initiatives has been given further reach, and we are therefore very grateful to this process. Grateful because this approach of intercultural dialogue is very necessary in the complex, modern world in which we live. Back in 2008, our organization published, and it was mentioned before, the White Paper on Intercultural Dialogue with the title Living Together as Equal in Dignity. The paper developed and summarized our understanding of this compass concept as a premise for the good governance and proper management of cultural diversity. It is a reflection of the values in which the Council of Europe is built: human rights, democracy, and the rule of law. With inclusive societies, therefore based on equal rights and dignity for all. This is about the way we live, the way we learn, and the way we work. It's about how we progress together. Our organization has provided the guidance and support that have helped our member states to put this approach into practice. Most of our recent and ongoing activities can be found in our action plan on building inclusive societies. These include our competencies and skills for democratic culture and intercultural dialogue, which educate and equip our young people for the future. Our Intercultural Cities Program that sets a gold standard for inclusion at the local and regional levels. And I'm very happy that this afternoon I will have an opportunity to explain in details how it works in practice, this concept of intercultural dialogue at local level. The activities of our North-South Center in promoting global citizenship among youth, and our Cultural Roots Network, which brings together Europe's peoples and places, sharing our history and heritage through cross-border exchanges. All these activities are underpinned by up-to-date legal standards for the management of cultural diversity and the achievement of societies free from discrimination. Judgments from the European Court of Human Rights, decisions from the European Committee of Social Rights, our individual conventions, and our monitoring body, the European Commission Against Racism and Intolerance, all of these play their part. Of course, the promotion of intercultural dialogue is not an event. Rather, it is a never-ending challenge. So too is the moral duty of turning that dialogue into action, the precise subject matter of this important forum, from the principles to action. It requires us to dispel ignorance about the other by means of education and openness. It requires us to ease the anxiety people so often feel by coming together instead in a spirit of tolerance, equality, and mutual assurance. And it requires the development of government structures and policies that pave the way to a sustainable future together. Interreligious dialogue, quality education, social inclusion, and the protection of minority rights. Ultimately, progress will be made on the basis of political will. And this is exactly what we feel here. Through you, Mr. President, we feel this strong leadership, this political will to really reach out and implement intercultural dialogue. In Europe today, we see the resurgence of extreme nationalism and populism, which so often seek to undermine minority rights, intercultural dialogue, and, as we heard so eloquently said, multilateral cooperation as well. So it is incumbent on all of us to counter these calls by stating the facts and standing up for our beliefs. A peaceful future in which dialogue forms the basis of cooperation, dignity, and mutually assured progress. This is the price we seek, and this forum, the Baku process, and your contributions here and when back at home are vital for winning it. Thank you.